Today, I'm going to go over how to add another email address to Gmail in your Google account. This will help you stay organized by accessing your business and personal email on the same Google account. Welcome to Tips with Tracy, where we go through the how-to of setting up your business online. If you want to watch more of my tips, tricks, methods, and strategies on setting up your digital assets in the future, be sure to subscribe down below and turn on notifications so you never miss another upload. Let's get to work. So I'm going to take a Gmail account, which I have used for demoing all this stuff, and I'm going to now attach my domain email, TracyGurney.com, to that Gmail account. So remember, I've already signed up for my Gmail. So I'm going to go there and I'm going to go to the gearbox over here to settings, and I'm going to see all settings, and I'm going to scroll down to, I'm going to move over to accounts and import. I'm going to click on here. And as you see, we've got my email. This is my Gmail account, which is attached to pretty well all my Google properties, or will be attached to all my Google properties, depending on where I am in the setup. What I want to do is I want to add another mail account. This is my hello@tracygurney.com. There it is. And I'm going to hit next. So I have two options here, and I never use the other option. I always import my emails from my other account so that they're sitting in Google. I'm not linked using a third party, so I'm not even going to look at that. I'm just going to import emails from my other account and hit next. So now I need to put in my credentials, put in the information that will help Google see where my mail is coming from. So where do I get that? I go back to my hosting, and I now need to log into there and go to my mail account. For this domain, I've just used A2 hosting. So far, it's been pretty good. I did a 3-year for incredibly super cheap. Like, if you're going to buy hosting, buy as much as you can, because that first shot is when they give you the best deal. After that, the renewal always goes up. So for me, this is a demo site as it's sitting right now, and so I'm not going to spend a lot of money on it. Okay, so I'm going to go to A2 hosting. Welcome back, Trace. I'm going to go cPanel login, and I'm going to scroll down to my email accounts. Gonna blur out some more stuff, and then I see Hello Tracy Gurney. And if I go connect devices, it will give me my settings. And I'm gonna use the ones in the blue, which are the secure settings. I'm not gonna use the ones, the non-SSL settings. So I'm gonna take that information, I'm gonna put it to the side, and I'm gonna go back here, and I'm gonna add my mail account. So I'm gonna add my mail account, hit next. I'm gonna import them from my other account. This is actually, my username is actually hello@tracygurney.com, not just hello. I'm going to get my password, which should be right in front of me, but I have to look for it. So I'm going to throw that in there. And then when I looked at my settings, my incoming server, and now I'm not doing port 110, I'm actually doing port 995, because that's what it says on my manual settings. So leave a copy and retrieve message on the server. I'm not going to do that. What that does is it will give me an email through Gmail. So I can always come here and get my hello@tracygurney email, but it will also leave it on the server so that I could actually access it on my A2 hosting server. But what that does is it just builds it up, and you have to clear it. I don't want my email to have take time away from me. I want it to be able to come into the mailbox, whichever one I'm using. And then when I'm finished with it, I'm either deleting, archive, or doing something with it. So I'm not going to leave a copy on my server. I'm always going to use a secure connection. I am going to label my incoming messages hello@tracygurney.com, and I am going to not archive the incoming message. So I'm going to add account. So now I can get anything that is sent from hello@tracygurney.com will come to this Gmail account. But I also want to send my mail as hello@tracygurney.com rather than it coming from a Gmail account. Just looks a bit more professional. So my name, email address, treat as an alias. I am not going to treat this as an alias. I want this to be a completely separate account. So I'm going to go next step. I'm going to do the exact same thing that we just did and put in my username and my password, and hopefully it's still there. I am going to use a secured connection. I have to put 465. Okay, and now I'm going to add my account. Okay, so there you see, congratulations, we successfully located your other server and verified your credentials. So now I can either go in and click on the link in the confirmation email, or I enter and verify the confirmation code. Let me just do that. And so now I'm just going to enter, I got the email from my hello@tracygurney.com email account, and I'm going to add that now, and I'm going to hit verify. I can send email as my Gmail account, or I can send it as hello@tracygurney.com, and I also receive all emails hello@tracygurney.com. I also at this point can say when replying to a message, I always want it to default to the Gmail account, or I can make hello@tracygurney.com my default. Now everything through this Gmail account will be as if it's through my domain. Anything going to my Gmail account is going to come in here. Anything going to hello@tracygurney.com is going to come in here. And I'm just going to feel very organized and happy. Don't forget to grab my guide on how to start your business online. Just click on the link in the video description below. Thanks for watching. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification button to get notified when I upload a new video.